Graphs have some additional properties that make them useful for modeling various types of data. Edges can have a direction, meaning the relationship between two nodes only applies one way and not the other. Directed graph is the term for a graph where the edges have a sense of direction. For example, if you're using a graph to represent travel plans, a directed edge can be used to show which city you start in and which you travel to. Often, one node will be the start and the other the end of the relationship or action taking place. You might describe the edge of a graph as the first node, a verb, the word to, and the other node. Here, it's from SF, travel to Tokyo. If you make a round trip and travel through the same two cities going in opposite directions, you might have two edges between the same two nodes, one representing each direction you travel in. An undirected graph has edges with no sense of direction. For example, if you have a graph of people and edges are drawn between two people who've met before, directed edges might be unnecessary. I previously mentioned that graphs can have cycles, but trees can't. A cycle happens in a graph when you can start at one node and follow edges all the way back to that node. Cycles in graphs can be really dangerous when you're describing algorithms. You might write some code to travel through the nodes in your graph, but if you have a cycle, you might just go through the same sequence again and again and again in an infinite loop. You often need to make sure the graph you're taking in as input is acyclic, meaning it has no cycles. One type that shows up often is a DAG, or directed acyclic graph. It's really just what it sounds like, a directed graph with no cycles.